There are very few... expectation.
Please.
Before they return!
They return.
A newborn.
Born new from this husk.
You know no creature like this. One that is more brain than person.
Remove us
from this body,
from this case. Free us,
please.
You notice edema. A swelling of the brain, causing pressure where it strains against the shell of the skull. Thousand years of humanoid history, elves, dwarves, humans, and more flash behind your eyes. A thousand years of humanoid history, elves, dwarves, humans, and more flash behind your eyes. A thousand years of humanoid history, elves, dwarves. Rush past. A dragon's wing, a silver sword, and a flash of your face seen through the strange woman's eyes.
Oh. My head. What is this? Squall. You are no thrall. Flakith blesses me this day. Together, we might survive. Mindflyer parasites. Unless we escape, unless we are cleansed, our bodies and minds will be tainted and twisted. Within days, we will be Geich, Mindflayers. First, we exterminate the imps. Then we find the helm and take control of the ship. We will address the matter of a cure for this infection once we reach the material plane. fury. I am death.
Take another dragon attack. We need to get out before it's too late.
I'll give it a shot.
No time for stragglers.
The construction is too alien. Nothing looks familiar.
This ship is crashing. Do you intend to die for a stranger?
Try that contraption next to the pod. They did something to it when they sealed me in.
The console appears dormant. The mechanisms are completely unrecognizable at first, but then you spy an empty socket. Nothing. The console remains dormant.
Whatever fits in that socket must power this thing.
Images appear in your mind. A brain, a Githyanki warrior. From the console near to the pod.
Are you satisfied? We need to go.
Keep looking.
Woman is trapped inside the pod. She doesn't notice you. As you place your hand on the pod, you hear something. A presence connected to the pod, commanding the person inside to change.
At the pull of a lever. How? If we are not purified, this may be our fate.
Will it preserve me? That cannot be our fate. Brain in a jar. This might allow those controls next to the pod.
Stares at you, weak and dazed. Console appears dormant. The console hums to life. But what is its purpose? Will it free the captive or transform her like that other unfortunate? pulsing glow and organic lines of the device make it seem more like a beating heart than a machine. This device is different from the one that caused the other captive to transform. Perhaps it will open the nearby pod. Suddenly, you feel a hideous squirming in your head. A parasite. Then discomfort fades, and another sensation washes over you. Connection. Authority. Brain of the console process your command and yield to it. A shiver runs across your mind. You feel sated.
Going to be my coffin. Thank you.
Your mind lurches into her thoughts. Her gratitude is mixed with wariness because you have a gith with you.
You keep dangerous company. Fair point. Looks like there's plenty of fighting ahead. Let me come with you. We can get off this ship and watch each other's backs along the way. Shadowheart. One moment. It's nothing. Trust me.
Enough of this chatter. We need to get to the helm. Now.
She's right. Lead on.
We are nearing the helm. Once inside, do as I say.
Who put you in charge? I'll trust my own judgment.
Kanyank. Deal with the gate after we escape.
Thank you. shouldn't have made it. Too much to bear.
Taking position.
You can hear
strike. As you wake, the tadpole squirms in your skull. Other than the infection, you're more or less intact.
A miracle, given everything you've been through. But it'll all be for nothing if you don't find help soon. The tadpole is a death sentence, and the clock is ticking. You need a cure.
Something to ask.
You're alive. I'm alive. How is this possible? True. Seems like we're the lucky ones, judging by all the corpses strewn about. I remember the ship. I remember falling. Then nothing. You might want to reconsider calling her a friend. Looks like she ran off without us. You're more concerned for her than she is for you, clearly. We need to take care of ourselves. First things first. We need supplies, shelter, and most of all, a healer. We might have escaped, but we still have these little monsters in our heads. We need each other, and we both know what's at stake. Can't think of better company. One thing, just before we go. I wanted to thank you again for freeing me. It would have been all too easy for you to run right past my pod, but you didn't. I'll remember that. Lead the way.
One day I'll catch a break. Something good here, I hope.
More of those wretched things.
Something the matter? Must we? No harm in a little mystery, don't you think? Easier's often less interesting. Besides, we've plenty of reason to rely on each other already. You can't confide in just anyone about a monster in your head. Thank you. I'm sure we'll get along perfectly well.
Maybe there's another entrance.
Jin!
In her name.
Time to rest. What path lies before me? There. A mindflyer.
You approach the dying monster. This is the thing that abducted you. You could end its life here and now, if only you didn't feel compassion. Compassion. The poor creature is on the brink of death, but there's still time. Give your life to save it, to nurse it back to health. But then the feeling slips. The creature's mind seems to focus elsewhere.
your minds fuse, lusting for something that is gone. But then its grip claws back with a vengeance, a vice locking your mind into obedience. It needs sustenance to survive, and with your very body, you can provide. Feel the creature's thoughts stumble against your magic, your will to resist. The monster lies exhausted, defeated. Its eyes, wet orange pearls, radiate malice.
Death is too good for it.
I've got one of those brain things cornered. There, in the grass. You can kill it, can't you? Like you killed the others? There. Can you see it? a sound. Not if you want to keep that darling neck of yours. And you, keep your distance. No need for this to get messy.
I need him alive. Stow that blade, or I'll show you just how messy things can get.
Promises, promises. But I have other business, I'm afraid. Now, I saw you on the ship, didn't I? Nod.
Streets. You try to hold the memory, but it fades to the worm. The light. The fear.
What was that? What's going on? The worm. Of course. And to think, I was ready to decorate the... Apologies. A kindred spirit. My name's Astarion. I was in Baldur's Gate when those beasts snatched me. Is that so? We clearly move in different circles. So, do you know anything about these worms? Turn us into... Of course it'll turn me into a monster. What else did I expect? Although, it hasn't happened yet. If we can find an expert, someone that can control these things, there might still be time. Well, yes, of course. But first things first. You know, I was ready to go this alone. But maybe sticking with the herd isn't such a bad idea. And you seem like a useful person to know. All right. I accept. Lead on.
just to put my hands on everything.
Time to see what new horror's waiting for us.
Trust no one.
Astarion's an interesting find. Let's hope any future acquaintances don't hold a blade to your throat by way of introduction.
Then I can crack that open.
Someone doesn't like visitors.
Anything of use? Strange coin. I wonder what it's worth.
does it open? No lock, no handle. How does it open? No lock, no handle? How does it open?
It's a bloody lock.
Something the matter?
Scribes. No sign of a struggle.
I wonder what was so subversive about their words that they commanded protection.
Even gods get left to rot in the dark. something over there.
I need a quick word.
So, we're resting here. Turning in for the night. I suppose. I'm not really sure what I expected, really. This is all a little new. The night normally means bustling streets, bursting taverns. Curling up in the dirt and resting is, a little novel. I'm in no place to rest yet. Today has been a lot. I need some time to think things through, to process this. You rest. I'll keep watch. The pleasure is all mine. Sweet dreams.
On I go.
Have a lot on my mind and, well, in it.
What are you talking about? I see. I'd be careful with astarion.
Trust is a rare currency. Not sure I'd spend it on someone who drew a knife on me moments after I met them.
Let's hope we rapidly find a healer.
You seem reliable. I think you know how important it is that we find someone who can cure us.
Good. We might even get lucky and find one right away. As I see it, we're overdue some good fortune. Rest well.
Here goes nothing.
Another step forward. Broken. Must have been here a while.
You think it's dangerous?
Of course it's dangerous. One of them
can't. I hear shouting up ahead.
We should check it out, but be careful.
Gate! Nobody gets in! Zevlor's orders!
That pack of goblins will be on us any second!
What's going on?
Goblins are on our tail! Open the gate, Zevlor, now!
You let goblins here? Where is the druid?
Please! There's no time!
The nine hells! Open the gates!
Blade
and suffer its sting.
Scout! Get to the high ground! Raiders! Charge the bastards! For the absolute!
On the way.
Blood comes easy these days.
Every last one of you!
Survival is all that matters. Try me.
Way.
My faith will protect me.
Time to kill.
Where do we go from here? These boots have seen everything.
That was the last of them. Inside, all of you, more may follow. Open the gate. Damn them.
They were tenacious. I wonder what they wanted here, other than bloodshed.
I just wonder if the grubby little beasts had any friends, and if they're nearby.
With haste.
Children here, you fool!
We was running.
You led them straight to us, and you let them take the druid too! Unbelievable!
Tell that to the dead at the gate.
Shut it, Horns! I'd be lying dead next to the goblins if you'd stalled any longer.
My duty is to this camp.
Oh, God forbid you risk your precious tail. But I shouldn't be surprised. Foulbloods ain't known for courage.
The armored man collapses, unconscious.
Enough. The goblins have found us. No doubt the beasts will be back. We need to pack up and leave. Immediately!
Something bigger fighting goblins for once.
Let's try to avoid any...
Now that's settled.
Thank you for your help out there. I'm Zevlor. Well met. I should warn you, visitors are no longer welcome in this grove. Whatever your business, I'd see to it quickly. The druids are forcing everyone out. This attack will only strengthen their resolve. There have been several attacks by different monsters. The druids blame us outsiders for drawing them here. Nobody's welcome anymore. They've started a ritual to cut the grove off from the world outside. We can't stay, but we'll be slaughtered if we leave. We're no fighters. Goblin got you. The druid Halcyn's a renowned healer, but he didn't make it back from Aradin's expedition. If it's not too serious, you could try his apprentice, Nettie. She's with the other druids in the inner grove. They've withdrawn there to prepare this damn ritual of theirs. We're refugees from Elturel. We took shelter here after gnolls attacked us on the road.
We were bound for Baldur's Gate,
and it was too late to turn back. Elturel had no place for tieflings after the descent.
The descent, an infernal conspiracy that had seen the entire city of Elturel be dragged to the hells.
So I hoped. But we've lost so many already. And more will die if we're forced out again. I've tried. Corga, their new first druid, won't even see me. You, though. I know it's not your business, but she owes you for saving this place. Perhaps you could persuade her for more time to prepare, if nothing else.
Really? We're messengers now.
We'd owe you a great debt. If we're forced to leave now, we won't make it to the city. You'll find the druids at the heart of the grove. Please, make them see sense before more lives are lost.
What's hiding here?
I care about our lives, our futures.
No, you just care about your stupid apprenticeship.
Get a feel for it.
Take that back, right now.
And again. Swing and swing and...
Covered in spots. No noses to speak of.
You ain't gonna shoot me. Your hands are shaking.
Put it down. She can't fight back.
That's the point. Get out of the way.
She didn't kill your brother, Arca. You're better than this.
Shoot before you lose your nerve, Tiefling. If you ever had it to begin with. Looks like the Absolute sent me a protector. You're gonna kill him too?
You, move! You're right. I wish you weren't. I really do. Damn you. Damn it! Why do you care if a goblin lives or dies? Can't say I understand that. Not sure I want to.
It's all right, Arca. Let's go.
I'm gonna bite the heads off. Ain't sure why you're protecting me. Don't care, neither. It's too late to make friends, warg meat. My tribe's coming. They're gonna burn this pretty place for the glory of the Absolute and hang you by your guts. Goddess. We're burning her name across the face of the world, we are. The Absolute is gold. She is. The blessing in the storm and the storm itself. Maybe she sent you to help me. And you will, if you want to save your skin. And if the teeth stick a few arrows in us on the way out of here, don't worry. Priestess Gut will patch us up. Got a whole lab set up. Cooks up potions that fix our lads, no matter how much of a beating they take. Could probably stick your head back on if someone was to chop it off. Mighty Booyog.
I'm not saying we should trust a goblin, but she sounds very useful.
Get me out of here, and I'll tell you where to find her. Deal? Then hurry up and do it. My tribe ain't as friendly as I am. You gonna open this cage or what? Well, hurry up. I got all the time in the world. You don't.
What to bring?
Let me out, you bunch of softies!
Seems simple enough.
You gonna open this cage or what? Well, hurry up. I got all the time in the world. You don't. You're gonna be sorry, every last one of you. You gonna open this cage or what?
What's up for discussion?
We've known enough grief this 10-day, traveler. Don't be the cause of more. Move along.
You're going to get us killed!
Swing and swing and parry.
The Blade of Frontiers. What a threat.
They're tough kids. Smart, too. The future's in good hands.
Thieves are all boring. Even your cages are boring.
First step is the hardest.
I already met your friend. You here to get me out of here? Well, hurry up. I got all the time in the world. You don't. You gonna open this cage or what? 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 Well, hurry up. I got all the time in the world. You gonna open this cage or what? Even if you did, you need me. Get me out of here, and I'll tell them what a good... You gonna open this cage or what?
Never wanted the easy path.
Please, let us through!
Let my daughter go right now!
She's a thief, Hellspawn! And you will wait for Corga's judgment. Now get back!
Oh, let me through, Mragrisham, or I'll rip your damn throat out!
What's inside?
Do all the damn rituals you want!
Come, Magrin. Give him a chance. You, get back! No. And you'll find trouble all the same, unless you get out of my sight.
A moment, Giona.
What? Oh, I understand. You. Apparently Corga wants to see you. Go ahead.
I do wish I could understand you.
You gonna open this cage or what? 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 You gonna open this cage or what?
Should mind my step. I want to have a word.
You gonna open this cage or what? You gonna open this cage or what? Well, hurry up. I got all the time in the world. You gonna open this cage or what? You gonna open this cage or what? You gonna open this cage or what? You gonna open this cage or what?
Moving in.
Not now. Please.
No traps, please. Here goes nothing.
I've never learned to converse with your kind.
This is madness, Korga. She's just a...
A what, Wrath? A thief? A poison? A threat? I will imprison the devil. And I will cast out every stranger. Girl. You mean parasite. She eats our food, drinks our water, then steals our most holy idol in thanks. Wrath, lock her up. She remains here until the rite is complete. And keep still, devil. Teela is restless.
Come, Korga. We took back the idol. Surely...
Do it. You intrude on the circle. You intrude on my mind. More proof that outsiders must never be trusted.
The snake's hiss of approval reveals its intentions. Should the child struggle, it is poised to strike.
Fair words. Child, take to the others word of my grace. Sivasif, Teela, to me.
Thank you, Korga. Master Halsin...
Halsin isn't here. Keep his name off your tongue, lest Teela pierce it. Go on. Say it. You think I'm a monster? First you urge grace, then you speak truth. You surprised me twice over. A shame the grace period ends. The viper's fangs have been bared. She must guard her brood. No matter. I took back the idol of Sylvanus, and the rite is resumed. We will seal the grove, free from harm, free of intruders. And mine perish if he stays. You showed great mettle at the gate. The mettle of a skilled sword for hire. I want you to provide your services to Zevlor. Offer to guide the Outlanders out of the grove. I'm sure they'll reward you well. They're to be gone before final prayer. If they are not, the Viper must strike. You will do more than speak. This tale ends but one way. With the Outlander rot cleansed, and the grove forever shrouded.
They did a number on you, didn't they? Does that hurt?
The bird's eyes are glassy. It's breathing weak.
I see you. Just give me a moment.
A moment.
Please, Medicatrix.
There. It's up to her now. Life or death. Now, what was it you needed? You found her, but I still don't know what she can do for you. Come here. Let's have a look at you. You seem healthy enough. A bit tired around the eyes, maybe. Crawled in. Some sort of bug? Or... Wait, did it look like a tadpole? But from your worst nightmare? All slime, teeth, and tentacles. I'll do what I can. Come, follow me. I might be able to help. We need to be quick. This way.
Shall we?
This one had the same problem as you. attacked us in the woods together with some goblins. Tadpole crawled out of his head soon after. I'll do the best I can.
I'm no Master Halsenmind. He'd have your tadpole out like that. Still, we have options.
You don't have to be here for this.
All right. Let's see what we can do.
Of course. Now, tell me what's been happening. Any symptoms? Strange events? Victims can identify each other. Not that the others know they're victims, of course. How'd you pick up the parasite? Halsen was desperate to find where all this was happening. A mindflayer ship? But Master Halsen was sure. Look, you've been straight with me, so I'll be straight with you. You're dangerous. If you transform here, we're all dead. But you seem like a good soul. You deserve a chance to save yourself. This is a vial of wyvern poison. Swear to me, you'll swallow it if you feel any symptoms. I hope it doesn't come to that, but thank you. Here. You know, I've spent my life treating folk and never once saw a mind flayer infection. Then suddenly, there's dozens of you. Maybe more. Master Halsen and I were tracking them, studying them, trying to figure out what the hell was going on. Because you should all be changing. There should be a small army of mind flayers out there. But you're not. Weird powers aside, you seem perfectly normal. You can't cure what you don't understand. And as much as I know about mind flayers, I can't make heads nor tails of this. It's one of their worms for sure. But this one gives you powers. Telepathic connections. And it doesn't turn you into one of them. Not yet, anyhow. Could be. But there's a lot we don't know. Infected. Folks like you have been converging on an old temple of Saluna. And I've no idea why. When Master Halsen heard the adventurers were heading that way, he saw a chance to get answers. Joined on the spot. Whatever he found there, he didn't make it back. I've sent birds to find him, but the place is rotten with goblins. And if my birds can't get close, what chance do I have? You, though. You're one of them. Technically speaking, I mean. They won't kill someone carrying their parasite. If you can find Halsen and get him out of there, we can discover what he learned. And perhaps he can save your life. How's that sound? I wish I could tell you more. But only those adventurers know what happened out there. All I can say for sure is they all went to the old temple of Saluna. And Master Halsen didn't make it back. Good luck out there. And if things start to go bad, remember the vial. Remember your oath.
One step at a time, Nettie. Come on.
Pretty boy. But I wouldn't...
Something over there.
Something in that vessel. Take a closer look.
tempers are rising. It's clear not everything you find is at your disposal. Tempers are rising. It's clear not everything you find is at your disposal.
Let's hope for gold.
Tempers are rising. It's clear not everything you find is at your disposal.
All's well that ends.
Not as bad as it could have. Have to keep going. Is someone singing?
Yearning suddenly fades as the spell breaks. You are free.
No, no. It's just a bit of water. I only want to listen. Just a little closer. Yes, everything's gonna be fine. Once I get there.
Got to keep moving.
Oh, you thieves are all boring. Even your cages are boring.
I'll give it a try.
I'm gonna bite the heads off your kids, and your birdies, and your dogs!
Hold out your hand, lady. Let me show you something. Go on. Take this ring. It's lucky. Call it heads or tails. Heads it is. See? That's the kind of luck you get from one of my lucky rings. I've got more where that came from. Real cheap, too. Interested? You got it. One sec. That's what I got.
You suddenly feel something moving against your back and turn.
I can't do this anymore, Mattis. I'm sorry.
Hey, are you here to trade or? Yeah, I know. I was standing right here telling her to rob you. I am sorry. Sorry we're still talking about this. Look, you caught her. Good for you. You aren't a chump like everyone else around here. Now, do me a favor. Make room for the chumps.
Where did I put that old bucket? You gonna open this cage or what? Oh, you thieves are all boring. Even your cages are boring. I'm gonna bite the heads off your kids and your birdies.